Hey, what's up? John Sonmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got this question about resumes and careers, experience. So I thought this was a good one, kind of a unique thing. I don't think I've encountered this before, but he says, the only thing that's been holding me back is my actual professional experience in software development. I have no idea what else I can do to get around this catch, 22 of not having experience. I had a resume professionally written to highlight my abilities in the best light as possible. I was also wondering how I could list my current lottery application that I developed as professional experience on my resume. I have no idea how I can list it as an actual job since I have no legal entity slash employer to associate this project to. So I think I might have cut off a little bit of that email, but I'll translate here. So basically he said he's in this position where he's got this application he's been working on, and he's got his resume professionally written, but he wrote the application for himself. It was some lottery application, and he wants to know how he could, you know, essentially it's an ethical question. Like, can I put that on my resume? Or even how could I put that on my resume? Because I didn't work for someone. What company did I work for? So this is a good one. So I have talked about doing mobile development, right? I think you can probably find one of my videos where I talked about doing why mobile development is so good. And I talked about in this the concept that I'm gonna highlight here, which is that one of the nice things that you can do today as a software developer working by yourself is you can just start a company, and you know, the company doesn't necessarily have to be profitable, but you can sell something in the app store, you could sell something in the store, and that's a company, right? I think, you know, too many people think so much inside the box, and they're like, well, it's got to be some other employer. I can't be my own employer. Well, yeah, you can be more than self-employed. You can actually have a company and work for that company and be a developer on that company, and you could put that on your resume. So, you know, yeah, when you get into the interview, you're not going to lie, and if they say, hey, you know, what is this company? Is this your own company? Did anyone else work there? You're going to say, yeah, no, it was just me, and I built this app, but I was selling it commercially, or, you know, I was trying to build a software company. I decided that I wanted to go work for someone else instead, right? You're going to be honest about it, but it's how that you frame things that makes a huge difference in life, right? The same truth can be framed in a different way. You know, it's one thing to say, oh, this was just some project I worked on by myself. Well, okay, that's one way of putting it, but can you frame it in a better way? Can you say, well, you know, I was, you know, obviously you were developing this application for a reason, but can you say I was building my own company and this was the app that I was building at that company and I was the lead developer and architect on this project? That's a much better way to frame it. So yes, you can put this on your resume, but you just come up with a company name and put that there and be honest when you get into an interview, you know, but this is gonna help you get your foot in the door more because that resume is gonna show that experience. So that's how I would play this. You know, again, it's up to you what you feel comfortable doing. I would probably, you know, for those of you that are listening that, you know, that are thinking about the situation or they're working on something now, you know, plan this ahead, right? Actually create an LLC or create your company and actually, you know, put it for sale, even if you don't sell whatever you're building, so that it is a little bit more legitimate rather than going, you know, after the fact and sort of reframing the story. I would try to do this up front. You know, anytime you're working on something, why not? You should, if you don't have a job right now, you should have a company, right? So that you can list on your resume and you can be building something for that company. It doesn't have to make money. You know, don't think so much inside the box. Think outside the box. It the world is not all these rules and what you think you have to do. It doesn't work that way in reality. You know, there's a lot more options than the straight, you know, forward path that everyone thinks that you have to go on. There's a lot of exceptions to the rules. So anyway, hopefully that helps you. If you have a question for me, email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com and I would love to answer your question. I can't answer them all. Sometimes it takes me a year to be honest with you, but the shorter and more specific your question is, the more likely that I'm going to answer it and do a video. So anyway, if you like this video, subscribe to the channel and I'll talk to you next time. Take care.